Welcome! In this series of videos, we will look at software add-ons for both the PowerBasic console and Windows compilers. Today we will look at revisiting the creation of your first CGI application on the Abyss web server. Here we are remote connected to another computer, Odroid 7. This computer is running Windows 11, and we're going to install the Abyss web server software from Aprelium. Abyss is easy to install and configure, and has a free version, which supplies all the functionality you need from a small-scale web server. I can highly recommend this server for use with PowerBasic, as I have used it extensively. Here we are installing the server on our computer. We're going to stick with all the basic settings. And once it is installed on a computer, we're then going to configure it for our use in PowerBasic. It defaults to installing on your C drive, but I'm going to amend this to put the software on another volume. The installation is quick and pain-free. Here we can see all the binaries and files that have been installed from Abyss web server. Following the installation, we need to do the first run to allow us to configure it. In your start menu, you'll have an entry for Abyss web server. Opening that up will allow you to click Allow Access to allow the application through the Windows Defender firewall. The application will then run to start the configuration. Your first task is to pick the language. So here we will just pick English. In the browser here, your next task is to set up your admin username and password. These will be used each time you wish to sign on to the web configuration tool. Now we can sign in. Now we can see on screen the Abyss web server console. This is used to configure the web server. For ease of use, I'm just going to add this as a bookmark so I know how to get into it the next time. Clicking the Configure button and then the General button takes you to a config page where you can specify where the website documents are actually held. This Documents page is currently a relative path to where Abyss was installed, currently htdocs. We can then browse to a new location to keep our web pages away from the Abyss software itself. I'm going to copy the index page from its current location to our new website folder. The index page is the HTML page a user will by default see if no URL path is specified. So now that we've created our new website folder, we will copy those files into it. This is what this page looks like, and you can of course replace this page with one of your own design. So now that we have replaced the documents path with our new website folder, we can save this change by clicking OK. We then need to restart the web server for the changes to be picked up. This will take a moment to stop and then reload the web server itself. Now that the web server is reloaded, we can attempt to connect to it. So we will return to the other computer and then enter the URL for our new website. And there on screen is our new website, showing the index page we have copied into our new website folder. So our next task is to configure the website to allow our PowerBasic CGI applications to run. First, we will create a folder to hold these applications under the website folder. We'll call that CGI bin, although it can be called any legitimate folder name. Now we need to tell Abyss where this folder is and that it will contain scripts. So if we go back to the configuration screen inside Abyss, and we click on the scripting parameters button, we'll see there is a number of configurable items here. We are interested in the script's path. There are three options here. We're picking the CGI option. Next, we have to put in the virtual path, which in this case is the / CGI bin, which we created earlier. Having entered that, we click the OK button, which takes us back to the previous page. This recognises that the configuration has changed, and when we OK that, we will be prompted to restart the web server once more. Once this has been restarted, our CGI path will be active. So any application we place inside this path will be executed when we call it. So that completes the setup of our server. We can now write our first PowerBasic CGI application. So how do we go about creating our very first CGI application? We're going to create this in the PowerBasic Console Compiler. What we have on screen in a moment is the skeleton of our application. We're going to include two library files, the standard Windows 32 API encode file, and also a PB CGI encode file. Now that these are both included, we can write our application. So we're going to return an absolutely minimalistic web page to the web browser which has called this application. And we're going to do that using a function within the PB CGI library. That function is called WriteCGI. And this function only takes a single parameter, and that is the string that contains the web page that we wish to display to the user. Now, you can create web pages using a number of different applications. However, this time we're going to hard code the HTML in the string that this function is going to process. We'll start the string off with two HTML tags. The HTML tag to start off with, and the body tag following that. These tags in HTML define the content of a web page in various sections. Everything between the beginning and the end HTML tag is part of the HTML document itself. Everything in the body tag is the body of the text that will appear on the screen to the user in their web browser. For each open tag, for example, HTML and body, there is a closing tag, preceded with the slash character. So we have HTML and body, followed by slash body and slash HTML. So that's the skeleton of our HTML document. Now we need to put the content in. Now we've added a piece of text, saying this is a basic web page. That's followed by a BR tag. That's the equivalent of a carriage return line feed in Notepad. This will move the text down to the line below, where it will say created on, and we're adding in two inbuilt PowerBasic strings, one for the current date and one for the current time. So if we save and compile this application, that is our first CGI application compiled. Now we need to copy over to the web server. To allow us to copy applications over to the web server easier, I've actually shared the website folder on the Odroid 7 computer. So all we need to do now is to copy the .exe over to the other machine. And there is our .exe in place. So if we now open up our browser, we can now browse to our executable. So this is the URL to our executable, HTTP, Odroid 7, the CGI bin, which holds all our CGI applications, and the name of the application to run. If we run that now, we get the message coming up saying this is a basic web page, followed by created on and the date and time. We may wish to make that text a little bigger, so we can add another tag to the beginning of our text. So we've added a beginning tag, h1, and an ending tag, /h1. This will make the text large on our browser page. So if we compile that, and we will copy that over to our web server. And we will go back to our browser and we will run it again. And there is our text larger. So in summary, what we've achieved today is we have installed the Abyss web server on a remote computer. We have also created a CGI application in the PowerBasic Console Compiler. While this is a very basic program, it does actually show you how to create a CGI application. In our next video, we'll move on to doing more complicated work with CGI applications. However, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.